physical fitness involved. So we'll see how fresh Manika Batra is here for this. Brilliant start, right?
It's a sharp start. First couple of points from the Indian. Yeah, I mean, table tennis players now are used to playing across events as well, playing a lot. But of course, there's a lot going on at the World Championships in terms of intensity. As you say, that physically and mentally, it takes a lot out of you to be playing across events, as they're both still doing at the moment.
Yeah, and because it's the World Championship, the stakes are so high. It's a very high-pressure tournament, you know, overall.
Love four.
And everyone who comes here fights at its best, right? You can see just amazing composure there from Manika Batra.
One, four.
Finally, a first point for Wong. God, I love the start from Batra. I mean, she is dialed in here into the first towel break. Five of the first 6 points for the Indian. It's, of course, extremely popular, dominating the fan vote at the moment. If you want to contribute to that, worldtabletennis.com, the place to go. I remember Sharath Kamalashanta giving me a good story about Manika Nehar, about it, that I think they were around, I think they were at the airport or whatever, and of course Kamal is complete legend and everything. We said, no one really had Manika with her. It's just like everyone was like, she's such a star. You'll know about that.
Yeah, she's now sort of a superstar in India. She's doing a lot of brand endorsements as well. So really, really nice for this wonderful sport of table tennis to have such stars like Manika, especially in a country like India, which is so dominant by just cricket all over.
Seven.
There's the equipment working nicely as well. If you think, we haven't talked about it yet, but we always should do with Batra, what she's got, the difficulties of playing her, their equipment now. And you're perfectly placed always to talk about that as well as, if you like, the trailblazer.
Eight.
For
yeah.
It.
Yeah, she uses the longer pimples on the backhand side. For those joining for the first time or new to table tennis, long pimples produces the exact opposite spin of what your opponent gives to you. And well, for Wong Shunrin also, she uses short pimples on her backhand side. So there's a lot happening on the table. You can see a lot of changes in speed and spin there. That's backhand opening was because...
Three.
Whoa.
Nine.
What if it made it way on the other side? I was speaking to Manika Batra's coach, and he told me that Manika is just absolutely confident coming in this game. Her preparation was very solid.
Four, nine.
Hope she didn't hurt herself there. Yeah. You know, that's sort of the disadvantage of being so tall. When there's a ball placed on exact body, it's hard to just move in that
Nine,
split
five.
Second.
Couple of points back for the Singaporean here. Batra still well placed, though, with the serves to come. Wow, nicely done there. Really forcing that last one through Wong.
Yeah, using her short pimples really well to be able to make that backhand down the line. It's just really effective when you change these ends. Just excellent serve. And, you know, yesterday in their mixed doubles match, Manika's coach was asking her to do this particular serve because they practiced it a lot, apparently, coming into Durban. And look at the coach. He's happy that she's finally doing it and getting those points.
7-10.
Game points as well. Service from Wong to save the first of them, but three more here for Batra.
That was a nice long, a lot of backspin in it. And when you're playing against players with against long pimples, it's always nice to do a lot of spin variations. Just a lot of backspin and underspin and no spin at all. It's very confusing for a long pimples player to play that.
10-9.
Thinking about timeout? No. Not here. Three of the game points gone. Still one more for Batra.
She goes again with that hammer serve that they've been practicing all this long.
20. Yeah. Had to work hard.
Take no tension. This is the game you have. And just go and play. But well, they must not be happy with Manika missing this one.
Well, it's the context really, isn't it? She's a game up, but actually in recent times, you think of the almost that comeback from Wong Xinru, it's carried on into the start of this second game. Six of the last 8 points for the Singaporean.
Ah, that's beautiful. Manika Batra's practiced this 10,000 and million more times. This turnaround forehand on the body is her strength, and she just does it so brilliantly.
Oh, right back, right back.
Perfect height advantage for Manika back in that point.
And you heard Amon there, he's very, very demonstrative there. Heard him go, yeah, yeah, at the end of that. Because as you say, they've been working on, you've brought a couple of the elements out. She's trying to bring them into the matchup here.
Yeah, they also did a lot of video analysis before this match. He told me that they worked on a few couple of points that was very important for Manika coming in against a Singaporean.
Jing Jun Hong, the coach of Wong Xinru. She made a good start to this second game. It's dissipated.
She sits right there. This is sort of the game construction that she's done. A first topspin and then a second winner cross court. And these are the hard ones, Guy, because that one came from the short pimple side and the ball literally sits down. There's a lot of, you know, sort of a flat ball, not spinny at all.
Straight through the middle there as well. playing beautiful series of points at the moment. How she handled the service there, fast long. Batra into the second towel break, leading by four.
Very good. Spectacular from her forehand side, Manika Batra there. That was a brilliant one from Wong Chun Ru, using her shot pimples really well. A backhand down the line, totally unpredictable. And I've not seen her do that enough in this game, Guy.
6-8.
Bit of a jittery and shaky situation for Batra there.
She'll know what happened in that first game where it became a lot tighter. Wong showing that she's a real fighter here.
Coming right
the way back now.
And that one was really hard. The push from Wong Chun Ru went right across Manika's deep back inside. It's really hard to get that back.
8-0.
Manika, take your time. It's okay.
Take your time. It's okay.
And there you go. He's asking her to make that forehand hammer serve that they've practiced all this while. Oh, that's a good change of angle from Manika.
9-8.
It's just those variations. You can see there, Wong never really fully set. Always on the move, keeping her on the move. Smart play from Batra.
And that's why Manika is such a top player, because she's got so many weapons inside her, and with the short pimples rubber and an equally sort of deceptive forehand, she's just a very, very strong overall player.
First game point saved. Another one here for Batra.
Yeah, nice gutsy move from Wong. Oh, this is getting really intense. Two game points saved from Wong Chun Ru, and Manika Batra right there is perplexed. Well, what the hell is going on?
Indeed, she may well be thinking that here with that run for Wong. Six of the last eight. Oh, brilliantly done by the Singaporean. Batra's getting a little bit handcuffed in the backhand exchanges initially. Can't really get out of them, Neha, at the moment.
Absolutely right. Wong Chun Ru keeping all the balls mostly on Manika's backhand side and then nicely switching it to the forehand at the right opportunity.
3 points in a row here. Game point now for Wong.
11-0.
That drifts long.
Look at her reaction. It seems like she just knew it, but it came out of the blue from her side.
That's the play, the playbook.
Well, that's the Manika Batra that India knows for sure. Step around forehand smash right into the body, and look at the coach. He's saying, yes, this is your game. Let's do it again.
See if she can here. Another game point. Third of the game for Batra. She's on that, popped up.
There you go. Again, that nice long forehand hammer service. guided really well by her coach. Seems like she came into Durban with a lot of practice in that particular sequence.
Eventually,
game to Butler.
Fourth game points the one. Wang Xinru looking to fight back, starts the third. Both these two having gone further than they managed at the last World Championships, both fell to first round defeats in Houston. Batra particularly, it was a painful one that. Losing in the seventh to Bruna Takahashi. Looking good here. Long way to go though, in the best of seven still.
Nice. That block there, it has a lot of backspin in it. And I mean, if you're Manika's opponent there, it's a lot of torture, right, to be getting those backspins again and again. Nice. I mean, Manika's been so dominant on her forehand side. And, you know, just a bit of a background growing up, Manika was so good in her backhand. And forehand was actually her weak point. But in the last 8-9 years, I mean, she realized that she got to work on that hand. And look at that. She's getting more points from her forehand now. Well, she twiddles and she switches. She moves. There's just so much happening right there from Manika Batra. Look at that twiddle and then a right slap cross court. No answer from Wang Xinru, and the coach is happy.
Yeah, it's the variation now, isn't it, Neha? Because Wang was doing a good job, particularly in game two, of keeping it to the Indians, keeping it to Batra's backhand side. But as you say, with the twiddle, just able to vary the rally now. And that's favouring Batra.
Lot of variations and a lot of surprise. I mean, that's the strength of her game, is to be able to catch the opponent off guard, bring in those surprise elements again and again.
Yes. 6-1.
Manika Batra, the first Indian table tennis player to win the highest sporting honor from the Indian government, the Major Dhyan Chand Khel Ratna Award in 2022. Yeah. And there you see the twiddle again. I mean, just learning how to twiddle your racket in between rallies is so hard. And then doing it so well and winning points over it. Well done, Manika Batra.
Seven.
She's struggling now, Wang here, in these rallies, these point constructions now. Batra just much stronger now in that moment, in the forehand in particular. She's getting the first strike in, and that was a difficult one to be able to try and make for the Singaporean. First couple of games have been tight, not this one.
And another one that a turnaround smash or a slap or a shot, whatever you want to call it. Not nice to be Manika's opponent currently.
2-10.
And, you know, she's also been in the situations many more times as compared to Wang Xinru. I mean, Wang Xinru is still so young, up and coming. But Manika Batra, I mean, already now 27, been carrying India's flag high since 2018, a two-time Olympian. A lot to prove yet.
3-10.
And then Ayaya says that, no, not that, let me come back. Get back to the strategy again.
Oh. 4.
It's 3 back. Still a long way back from here for Wong. Good quality there, though. Playing with width. And that will do it nicely for Batra, who's on top here, firmly so.
Oh, that was beautiful. I mean, she's not done in this match so far, making a first attack and another one. That is good strategy against a long pimples player.
Yeah, it's big really in Singapore. Talk about the development, because of course they're two top players on the women's side for many years. Feng Tianwei, also Yu Mengyu as well. Yu is taken up a coaching role there back in Singapore.
1-2.
Feng as well, I believe, will be involved in that respect. But they've moved on from there. But they've got these fantastic players to develop the next gen. I mean, Gao Ning is here, of course. Commonwealth Games gold medalist, excellent player. It's great to have all those players, isn't it, in development.
Yeah, and India and Singapore have been tough competitors at the Commonwealth level, and at least in the women's side, all of them would have played against Manika Batra. And if they're watching back home, they literally know what to do right now. Only if Wong Shinru can actually execute those strategies. And this time the forehand service is not that effective. A nice flick from the Singaporean. Again, it seems like she has so much inside her, a lot of weapons, but I'm not seeing it come again and again. And that's the difference between...
This is really good from Wong. Apologises there, but good response here. Mentally as much as anything.
And a lead for her for the very first time in this entire match. Oh my God, that was a pimple forehand shot. Notice again, she twiddled the racket. And the ball came on the forehand, and she was able to make that forehand sort of a countery loop.
6-4.
Big on her, really. And the lead is whittling down here, and I felt the timeout. I was about to say the timeouts were both. Resuming here off the timeout. Still a lead of one here for Wong. Brilliant from Batra. Not to be denied. Very keeping a good position there, quite close to the table as well, dictating.
Yeah, this is Manika Batra at her best. I love how nicely she's switching and finding those corners, the deep ones, onto the body. Just very smart play from Manika Batra.
Seven, six.
Again, an excellent use of forehand serve again, forcing the opponent to actually make a back and a topspin, and then giving a very equally backspin block. Yeah.
playing the big moments, you feel here, so well, Batra, through this match.
Yeah, and Manika has been known to play the right things at the right times, right? This is the moment when it really mattered for her to bring her A game up, and she did it so well.
6-9.
Can't really afford that. Gift of a point, Batra's way, puts her two away. Yeah, it's just too good, really. She's not to be denied here.
Yeah, fantastic forehands from Manika Batra. That long chop on the backhand side and then turning around and using the forehand smash really well. Just mark of a brilliant long pimples player.
10-7.
What did that happen, right? There?
Yeah, look comfortable, Batra, in the rally there. Slightly strange finish. Still three more match points here. That's where she's been very, very good, punching through Batra cross table. It's been profitable for Wong that.
Yeah, the short pimples actually allow you to do that only if she can do it again and again. This is getting tight for Manika Batra. But she's done
11,
it
eight.
Well.
Game
that twiddle again,
Batra
surprising the opponent. The twiddle and a backhand.